You know who I be, they call me Snapside. I play that Call of Duty, schooling all the newbies. If you down to learn, then go and press play, 'cause I'm only down aiming for that first place.
Yo, yo, what up, everybody? It's your boy, Mr. Slapside. We back with some PDW gameplay, and I pretty much want to share some tips with you guys on how I acquire 100 kill games. And the reason why I'm using the PDW is because this is the most comfortable gun for me on this map. I don't really like to use assault rifles on this map because it forces me to play a little bit more passive. I can't really initiate the process and get up in their spawn, clean them out, and stuff like that. So that's the reason why I'm using the PDW. And Meltdown is a really close quarters type of map, so you definitely want to use the SMG in this map and just keep it moving. Try to really play the objective, but at the same time learn how to flank them out. A lot of people like to just pretty much camp at the base, camp behind the base, whatever it may be. So just hit the left, the right, see what's going on that way. But the guns I like to use for high kill games is the AN94 and this particular SMG. But I do like the other guns in this game, but I don't know, it just really depends. I mean, you gotta get lucky too. Like, when you get into a lobby, you gotta make sure your enemy is down to stay in, because most of the time when they get their stuff pushed in, they just pretty much wanna quit right away. And I don't know what it is, they just don't have any pride or whatever. So it is what it is, you know, we all get annoyed by this game here and there, and that's just the way it is. But lately, guys, playing this game, I've been pretty tired because I've been playing on my cousin's account more, right? And when I play on my cousin's account, I pretty much don't have the energy to play on my account, and I can't really record gameplay and stuff like that on his. So I'm not really like going for gameplays anymore. I'm just pretty much playing the game for my own fun and stuff like that. And you know, it's just really changed. Like I said, guys, I keep saying this, ever since my other YouTube got terminated, it's been pretty hard to pretty much condone a lot of energy into this gameplay stuff. But I am here still, like I said, and I'm still gonna supply you guys with really beast games, real high score lines, and just try to give you guys as much tips as possible. I mean, you can see I die there. I didn't really know where he was at, so hey, you know, I mean, you gotta die once in a while. But pretty much my philosophy on having the swarm out, if you have flak jacket, you could kind of like rush in there, and I'm not sure if the swarm kills you if you have a flak jacket, but it may kill you because it's your own swarm. But I don't know, I just feel like I'm more aggressive towards the enemy when I have flak jacket, because I pretty much take away one way of dying. I mean, I take away the lethal way of dying from grenades and all that. So that's the reason why I love flak jacket. Lately, I've been using flak jacket a lot. I mean, why not use it if your enemy's not going to even get a spy plane? But if they get a spy plane, you definitely want to run that ghost, and that's just the way it is. But it just seems like now that this game has been out for quite a while, the enemies are getting a little bit more weaker. A lot more people are buying the game, more casual people are playing, so it really goes in my favor. I'm getting a lot more good games for you guys, and that's one of the reasons why, you know, when Call of Duty's out for a while, we understand the game. The vets start to really pick up on everything, and the enemies, they're just really, really slacking. But you can see right here, I'm pretty much in clutch mode, really trying to see what's going on. Trying to get as many kills as possible before I go into the next round, because I want to bring a lot of momentum with me into the second round. But you can see this first round was pretty nice the way I played it. It was real aggressive, real running gunny. But you're going to see in the next round, I'm pretty much going to get real conservative. I'm going to really measure all my kills. I got to like really think about what I got to do, because it gets really tough on the second. And you know, when you're going for a 100 kill game, you definitely want to have a high kill round of a 50 plus at least. You got to have one round with 50 plus. So the first round I go 70-2. Now we're up to the second round, and in the second round I'm 70-2. So I'm like, you know, if I'm 70-2, if I get a Lodestar, I could probably average about 15 kills with a Lodestar. So I'm doing the math in my head, and right here I got an EMP grenade on me. I'm pretty much using this green guy right here as bait. I'm like, you know, if he likes to pretty much watch that door, I'll let you die first, and then I'll kill the guy. I know it's pretty messed up, I wouldn't do that to my real teammates that I play with, but green guys do stuff like that. You don't want to be in front of the green guy because he'll get you killed. He usually has a loud gun and he'll blow your cover and all that good stuff. So definitely use your green guys or whatever to its advantage. You want to use green guys as bait, you want to use them as a shield, a human shield. I know it's kind of messed up, but hey guys, I mean, I play Call of Duty a lot, and green guys never have your back, so you want to use them as a shield. So definitely do that. But you can see I'm pretty close to this Lodestar. Got a counter up. I'm really thinking about it. I'm like, you know what, got to use my environment as much as possible, if you're feeling like you're getting shot a lot, guys, and your KD's not up to par, really try to head glitch a lot. Use your environment, use your flank routes, I'm sorry, and make sure you could just do what you got to do. But right here, I'm trying to really check it out. I'm checking out the scenery, and there's no one here, and it's just funny to me. You know, I don't really want to go on the flag right away, but since there's a green guy around me and I got a spy plane up, I understand where they're kind of at. It looks like there's one guy in here and there's more at C flag. So I'm like, you know, help me get this flag, please. And everybody does get on it because everyone wants to get some points up. So after that, I'm really just trying to get this last kill because this is pretty much just clutch mode. Really trying to get this low star. That way I can acquire the 100 kill game. And right here, I'm like, got it. You know, I was telling everybody, I was like, yep, that's it. 100 kill game. Got the low star. As long as I don't die while I'm in the low star, I got the 100 kill game. I was telling myself that. You just got to believe that you're going to pretty much get that 100 kill game once you have the low star. And I get the dogs right here. And I just got to let these dogs build up to the swarm. You know, pretty much right here, it's all smooth sailing. I pretty much work hard for all these high score streaks. And I love this part. You know, I think this is the easy work. You know, you get to really relax now. You know, you grinded hard. It's all a hard days of work. And now you're... now it's your time to relax and just, you know, let your score streaks go ham. So we all know that that's pretty much the philosophy of using these high score streaks to swarm and all that. And that's just the way it is. But hey, man, I mean, it is what it is, man, right? But right here, I'm pretty much just smooth sailing, man. Take this guy out. It looks like he pretty much retreated. He's just like, you know what, I give up. I'll just let this guy kill me. That's what he pretty much said. And one of the things cool about this gameplay, guys, is that it was on a 3-bar, and that's really awesome. You know, I don't really do good on 3-bars, and to get a 100 kill game on a 3-bar, I don't know what happened, man. It was a really good 3-bar, but right here, I'm pretty much gonna rush your spawn, see if I could just get a lot of points and stuff like that. But you know what, guys, I hope you guys enjoyed this 100 kill game. I know that I don't really post up 100 kill games frequently, but when I get a chance, I will post it up for you guys. I mean, I do get 100 kill games, but like I said, I'm usually getting those on my cousin's account, and he doesn't have a capture card, and you know the theater lobby is all messed up on this game. So I hope you guys enjoy. Just have a really good time, guys, with this game. You know, really enjoy it, guys, because it's a really good Call of Duty. From every Call of Duty I played, this is the most balanced, and the only thing that's the downfall is the fact that you lag. But we go 114-2. Peace out, y'all. It's your boy.